Thanks for watching Power Flow Vinyasa Yoga. We'll be using a couple blocks today if you have them, but know that you are totally free to use your own body and your carpet or your floor if you don't have a mat of any kind. And whatever we end up doing in this next hour, let it be a place for you to feel and move and breathe and connect as we move through different energies in the body as they come and as they go. So we'll start seated. Sit yourself up on a pillow or some blocks. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. Breathe in and out. Place your hands on your belly, your middle fingers touching towards your navel. Take a breath in through the nose. On the exhale, breathe out the mouth, feel the belly draw in towards your spine. Inhale. Exhale, draw the navel slightly in and up, contracting the space between your pelvic floor. Inhale. And exhale. One more like that. And exhale. If you're on your block, place it off to the left-hand side and come onto your hands and your knees. As you find your hands and your knees, inhale, finding your cow position. Exhale, round into cat. Inhale. Waking up the spine, exhale. Claw them out with your finger pads, feeling the lift of the domes of the wrists and the hands so you don't collapse the shoulders. Spread the toes wide as much as you can, engaging through those feet. Inhale from here, reach your left arm forward, pulling it back into its socket. Reach your right leg back. Hold those two points of action as you inhale, and as you exhale, slowly bring your left elbow towards your right knee. Inhale back. Exhale, contract, tone, and lift. Inhale, reach. Exhale, gather. Two more, reach out. And gather in. Out, in, release. Switch sides, take your right arm forward, left leg back, pulling the arm and leg into their sockets. Exhale, curl the left knee and right elbow in. Inhale, out. Exhale, curl in. Reach out. And in. Couple more. Come back to tabletop position here. Turn your hands so your fingers face towards your knees and your wrists face towards the front of the mat. Inhale, finding your cow. And exhale, rounding the tailbone first, chin comes in last. Cat. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, round. Tuck your toes. Place your palms down. Tuck your toes, lift your hips up to your first downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Find that nice lift in the hands, Hasta Bandha. The lift of the hands, the gait of the hands. And find Padabandha in the feet, feel the lift at the three points of the feet, the big toe, baby toe, and circle of each heel, even if the heels are lifted. We'll be here for a few breaths. Reach your hips back and away from you as you tip your pelvis forwards.
hug the arms and the legs energetically together, isometrically firm the muscles, hugging them to the bone. Inhale, bend your knees, step your feet to your hands and fold over your legs. Uttanasana, forward fold. Use your blocks if you have them. Inhale, lengthen your chest halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach the arms up overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center, Pranamanasana, Anjali Mudra. Inhale for all. We'll start with some sun salutations here. Inhale, reach the arms all the way up. Exhale, bend the knees, hinge and fold. Inhale to your halfway lift, hips back, chest forward. Exhale, place the palms back, step back to your high plank, Valakasana. Always often lower the knees if you need. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You can lower down knees, chest, and chin, or lower down to your belly, pulling the arms back. Point your toes to this first one, pull your wrists back for Cobra Pose, Bhujangasana. Push down to the tops of the feet, lengthen up to your toes. Exhale, lower down, tuck your toes. You can press back to tabletop, to child's pose, or to high plank, back to downward facing dog. Breathe. Feeling every finger pad and every toe pad as a foundation. Inhale, bend your knees. Step the right foot and the left foot forward, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, reach the arms up once again. Exhale, fold. Halfway lift as you inhale. Forward, forward as you exhale, walk it forward and back into high plank pose. This time we go lower down, halfway, and then all the way down. Point your toes, find a high cobra this time, tenting your fingertips here. Press down through your pubic bone and the tops of your feet. Breathe in. Exhale, lower down. Tuck your toes, press back up to your plank to downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward, bending the knees. Step the feet forward and fold. Halfway lift, inhale. Forward, fold, exhale. Drag all your spine up slowly, one vertebra at a time, reaching the arms up overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, reach the arms up. Sit back into Utkatasana chair pose. And as you sit back in the chair pose, lift your chest a bit higher, send your hips back a little bit lower. Contracting between your sit bones, pelvic floor, belly firm, and ribs pulled back. Inhale, exhale, fold forward. Find your high plank pose, walking forward and back. Breathe in. Exhale, lower down to a little push up, but this time press back up. Bend and lower. And press back up. One more, lower, press back up, and lower, and finding cobra, high cobra, hips up or down. Exhale, child's pose for a breath. Exhale, walk the hands back a bit, tuck the toes, downward facing dog. Inhale, reach your right leg back. Exhale, step your right foot to your right thumb. Turn your left toes a bit on an angle and then reach the arms up for warrior one. You can bend the elbows a bit here if you like to get a little more relaxed in the shoulders. Hug your inner thighs together and let your right hip come back a little bit as your left hip comes forward. Good, keep that as you push through the outer edge of your left heel and sit more to your right thigh. Interlace your hands behind your backs, reach your shoulders together as you lift up. Exhale, bow inside of your right thigh, keeping your shoulders straight back behind you. Combo warrior. Now take your left hand a bit wider, maybe on the block, and reach your right arm up for a twist. Rolling the shoulders back. Hug your legs together as you push your feet apart. Exhale, release that right hand down. Step the left foot forward and fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward, forward, step it back. High plank position. Come forward. This time lift your right foot off the ground and bring your right elbow to your right knee. Left knee, forward, back, and down. Left, to the left, to the right, forward, back and down. Lower it down for three. Look forward, keep your gaze up a little bit, and then finding cobra or upward facing dog or Dvanutta Svanasana. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe in, and out. Inhale, reach your left leg back, three-legged dog. Exhale, step your left foot to your left thumb, turn your right toes out at an angle. Doesn't have to be a set degree. Sit into your left thigh as you reach out for warrior one, second side. Inhale. And exhale. Take your hands behind your back as you interlace the fingers. Let your pointer fingers reach behind you. Lift your chest up. Exhale, bow inside that left thigh. Pushing away through your right foot. Sitting into your left thigh. Release the right hand on a block or on the floor. Reach the left arm forward and up and twist open towards the left. Exhale, release. Turn the right toes face forward. Step it forward, standing forward, forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward, forward. Chair pose, Utkatasana, fierce pose. Inhale, reach the arms up, standing. Bring your hands to heart center. Good. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, sit back, Utkatasana. Exhale, forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Walk your feet, walk your hands forward to your high plank position. And then slowly lower down for five, four, three, two, one. Cobra, up dog, your choice. Exhale, reach the hips back, downward facing dog. Inhale, reach your right leg back. Bend your right knee this time, stacking your right hip on your left hip. Anchoring through your left heel as you keep that, reach up and find that opening to the right thigh, waist, and hips. Keep heavy to the hands, heavy to the left heel, lift up. Exhale, neutralize, bring your knee to your chest. Inhale, back. Right knee to right tricep, maybe touching the elbow. If you want, lower down to a little tricep push-up. Come on up, reach it back. Right knee to left elbow, hug, hug, lower, press up. Bring it back. Good. Set the right foot between the palms and pause. Now this time, come up to high lunge, so the back heel is lifted off the mat. I'm going to bring my elbows in line with the shoulders for a little bit more of a chest opening here, bringing the shoulder blades one to the back. Keep that as you sit more into the front of the thigh and push off of the left toes. Squeeze those inner thighs, gathering through Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, pelvic floor, navel. The shoulders come back and with the chest lift, and pull the sides of your throat back, Jalandhara Bandha. Good, inhale. As you exhale, take your hands down on either side of your left foot, or right foot, sorry. Reach your right arm up for a twist this time. Revolving your waist and spine. Exhale, release the right hand instead of the right foot. Walk your right foot as wide as the mat and slide your left knee down to the floor. You can take your chip bone walk and place your left knee on top. I highly recommend it, or put a pillow or a folded blanket. Now from there, you can stay. You can take your hands on blocks inside of your foot, and you can also come down to your forearms if you make sure your shoulder heads stay on the back in the safe alignment. Breathe in and out. Next option here, you can come up to your palms if you're on your forearms, place your right hand on your right knee, and turn your right toes out in an exhale. Breathe in and out. Next option here, you can bend your left knee, taking your left heel towards your bum, send your hips back and reach your right arm forward. Reach the right arm up, back, and towards the top of your left foot. Now from there, pull your hips back and reach the shoulders back. Lengthen your tailbone, lift up to the crown of your head, breathe in. And then breathe out, keep holding it here for another breath. Slowly release the left foot, bring the right foot back to the block. Walk the right foot back between the hands and lift your left knee off the floor with the toes tucked. Separate your blocks, step your right foot back to plank position. Inhale forward, exhale lower, inhale, exhale downward facing dog. Inhale, reach your left leg back, bend your left knee, stack up and do the right. Reach out through your waist, push through your hands. Pointing through the left toes, really open up the left quadricep and left hip. Exhale, bring your left knee towards your nose. To the left elbow. To the right elbow. Bring it back. Bring the left knee to the left elbow. A little tricep push-up. And up. Bring it back. Step it forward. High crescent lunge, Anjaneyasana, left foot forward this time. Reach the arms up and maybe find your cactus shape. From here, sit down a little bit further. Push off the right toes even more. Hug your inner thighs together and engage your glutes just a slight bit. Inhale. Save for the exhale. Coming into our open twist, take your right hand wide, reach your left arm up for a twist. Exhale, place the hand inside the foot, walking your foot wide. If you have your block handy or something in between, find the right knee on top. Walk your left foot wide, hands inside of the left foot. Option to have your foam blocks or anything in between. From there, take the top of the right foot down and start to sit deeper into your lizard lunge. Keep drawing that belly in, shoulders back. Now if you wish, go ahead and slowly take your left hand on your left thigh. Turn your chest open towards the left, reaching space between your left hip, left armpit, rolling the shoulders towards the back. Next option, you can stay here or bend the right heel to the bum. Lift your hips back a bit and reach your left arm forward. Plug it in, reach it back towards the right foot. And then from there, pull your hips back, lift your chest up and reach back through your shoulders. Push down into the hand,
of the right on the block or fingertips, whatever you have at your access. Exhale, slowly release. Walk your left foot back between the blocks. Reach your right knee off the ground, popping it up. Now from here, take your blocks on their highest settings. You're using them beneath your hands. From there, start to step your right foot forward and find a standing forward fold with the blocks beneath your hands. Inhale. And exhale. Good. From there, take one of your blocks and place it between your upper inner thighs. Nice and awkward. Sit back into chair pose. Awkward pose. Good. Feet can be as wide as your hips apart. From there, bring your hands to the heart center. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, take your right elbow to the outside of your left thigh or knee. And from there, see if you can make a ball with your right hand. Make a fist and push the left palm flat into the knuckles of the right fist. Squeeze your block, firm your belly, sit back a little bit lower. Inhale to your left and to your right. Exhale. Inhale, release. Exhale, fold. Sit back to the chair pose once again, keep your shoulders relaxed. Inhale. Exhale, palms together, twist towards the right. Left elbow towards the outside of that left of that right thigh and knee. Cup your left fist with your right hand. Bring the elbows towards each other and roll your chest over towards your right this time. Inhale, release. Exhale, fold. Good. Release the block on the right side of the mat. Roll yourself up one vertebra at a time. Inhale. Exhale, palms to heart center. Nice. From there, inhale, sit back in the chair pose. Exhale, forward fold. Walk your hands to plank pose. Come forward. Exhale. Inhale into your back bend of choice. Exhale, downward facing dog. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Inhale, reach your right leg back. And exhale, step your right foot between your palms. Turn your left toes out a bit wider than last time. Stacking the right knee over the ankle. From there, walk your hands inside of your left foot and walk it off to the top left corner of the mat for a down dog lunge. So think like warrior two in the lower body and downward dog in the upper body. Pull the legs together as you push the feet apart. And then walk the hands back. Keep the right hand low. Take your left arm forward. Plug it into your shoulder socket. Press down through your legs. Slow and controlled as the right arm comes up naturally into warrior two. Virabhadrasana B. From there, let your right knee be somewhere towards the outer edge of the foot so that we can see the big and second toe. Reach out through your left fingers and right fingers accordingly as your shoulders come together. Sit a little bit more into that front thigh if you want a bit more dynamic heat in the hips. Turn the palms and face up to the ceiling. Reach your right arm up and take the right hand behind your head with the left hand on the back thigh or around the front of the right hip. From there, turn your chest forward if you're coming with me and lift up through your chest. Sit more through your right thigh but keep pushing back through your left foot. Come back into warrior two, inhale, feel, notice. Good, from there, walk your left foot up a little bit here, taking your hands on your hips. From there, bending into the right knee, arms come back in line with your shoulders, take your right arm forward into the inside of the right leg, or take your block in
place your palm on top as you bring your left arm up towards the ceiling. Roll your shoulders back and hug those legs in as you push the feet away. If you want to find an extension of the arm, left arm coming forward towards the front, brushing your left armpit across your ear. Last breath here. And then from there, inhale, come back up to warrior two. Heel toe your left foot in a little bit more. Take a slight bend out of the right knee, setting up your triangle position, Trikonasana. Take your arms and shoulders in line, reach your hips back, shoulders forward, and taking the hand on the block if you want, and reach the right arm down as you push the left arm up. Again, if you want to find Uttita Trikonasana, extended triangle, please go for that. Last breath here. Good, and then from there, take your left hand on your left hip. Place your block on the outside of your right foot, and then start to come high into your left toes. That's option one. Option two, right block hand comes forward. Stack your left hip on top of the right for half moon, Ardha Chandrasana. Now from there, if you want, you can bend your left knee, point your left toes, reach the left arm forward, up and around the socket, and perhaps grab the top of the left foot for Ardha Chandrasana or sugarcane pose. Bend your right knee, press the left hand and foot against each other. Open up your chest, leaning in towards that right hand, push away from the ground for three, for two, for one. Slowly, like a ninja, step back into your wider stance, replace the block where you once had it. And then stay with your left hand on your left hip. Turn your chest forward on either side, right hand, left hand comes down. Good. From there, walk your left foot in a little bit, turn your left toes forward out to the side for pyramid, Parsvottanasana. And then take your hands on your blocks once again. Determine the width and the length of your stance so it feels comfortable for your skeletal variation. And from there, inhale, lengthen your chest forward. Exhale, bow your chest over your right thigh and shin. Reconnect with your pelvic floor, Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, navel drawing in and up, and your ribs pulling back. From there, walk your left foot up a little bit more. Take your left hand on the right block so your left hand crosses over to the right. Good. From there, using your fingertips or your left hand on your left shin, take your right hand on your right hip and start to revolve your torso open to the right for Parvritta Trikonasana, revolve triangle. Reach your right arm up, roll your shoulders back, continue breathing in here. One more breath like that. Exhale, slowly release. Place your hands back on either side on those blocks. Walk your foot back for a set. Walk your blocks forward. Come and lift up into standing L shape. Standing L pose. Turn your left toes down towards the ground. Lengthen your sternum forward and point your left toes back. Then you're going to skin the wall behind you. Charge your right leg. Lift out through your waist in all directions. From there, slowly bring your left knee in towards your chest. Take your hands on your hips and try to stand up tall, coming into a standing position here. Left knee in towards your chest. Woo! That'll cause some balance. And there goes my head. That's all good. Anyways, breathe in. And breathe out. Turn your left knee onto the side. Take your left ankle over your right thigh. Take your palms together as you sit down into standing pigeon pose. Often have your hands on your blocks so they can hold you from the ground. From there, send your hips back and a bit lower, but keep lifting your chest away from you. So your tail is lengthening behind, the crown of the head is reaching forward. inhale. If you have a practice with Ekapada Galabhasana, flying pigeon, or one leg stage pose, please go ahead. Coming out of that, if you went further than where I'm at now, coming back up, and we come up to our fingertips. As you come to our fingertips, cross your left foot outside of the right foot, like you're taking a little kind of curtsy bow, and then walk your hands towards the left. Bending into your left knee, straightening through your right leg, and feeling that stretch of the outer side of your right thigh through the IT band. And then all you need to do to switch sides, take that left foot, cross it behind the right, walk your block off to the right. It's going to feel different, of course, because we haven't done the second side of that longer sequence. Inhale. And exhale. Nice. From there, untangle your feet. Walk your feet back a little bit. Sit into Utkatasana to neutralize. Exhale, face the palms down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Flex your palms down. We're going to step or jump back with the elbows bent if you're jumping back. Inhale. Exhale, inhale, back bend, exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, reach your left leg back, and step your left foot between your palms. Walk your hands inside of your right foot, training the right toes down, of the left foot, sorry, and walk your hands forward off on the angle for down dog lunge on the left side. Good. Feel that heat building in the body. Breathe in. Notice the hands and the feet. Stay earth connected. Stay connected to what's touching the floor. Inhale, walk your hands back. Mm-hmm. And then from there, bend your left knee. Take your left arm inside. Good. And from there, reach your right arm up, back, and behind as the left arm comes up. Now we're in warrior two on the left side. Hug your legs together as you push your feet apart. Really feel that you're extending up those fingertips as you plug those shoulders into your back. Breathe into your back, upper ribs, your lungs. Turn the palms up now. Reach the left arm forward and up behind the head. And you can take your right hand around the left thigh if it can reach as you find a little bind. And reach your chest through and up. Push away through your right big toe, especially here. Waking that inner right thigh, adductor region. Inhale, release back to warrior two. From warrior two, finding your way into side angle position. Maybe extended. Again, have your block handy if you want to use it. Otherwise, make sure that left hand is super grounded on the mat so you're not losing connection to the floor. Keep turning your right ribcage back, left ribcage forward as you inhale. Awesome. From there, come on back up. Walk your right foot in a little bit here. Take a side bend on the right knee. Reach your arms in line with your shoulders again. Here we go, Trikonasana. Inhale into the pose. Remembering that even though this is a more asana-centered practice today, that we are still focusing on the non-physical elements to support and complement the physical body. So feeling the prana, the energy rising up, inhaling through each breath. Each exhaling, connecting you more towards your foundation. Maybe finding that extension for a few breaths. Turning the chest open just a bit more. Maybe smelling that beautiful armpit of yours. God, it smells good. Inhale. You can't take yourself too seriously in practice. You gotta laugh a little bit to have a good time, right? Inhale, come on up and do your warrior two. Good. From there, different way into half moon. Instead of coming down, we'll stay up. Take your right hand on your right hip, taking your left hand on your block. Walk your right foot up a little bit and lift your right leg back, finding your balance point. Press into the block, roll your right hip back over your left hip, perhaps reach your right arm up, or half of your right arm. From there, bend your right knee, take your right hand towards the top of your right foot, leaning back as you find sugarcane position on the second side. Keep your belly firm, draw your ribs in, try not to collapse the front of your torso here. Lift up higher. Slowly release back into that warrior two base. Good. And from there, turn your right toes slightly in, walk your right foot up a little bit, setting up for our revolve tri-hole on the second side. So you can shorten your stance, narrow your stance if you need. Walk your right hand outside of your left foot or on the block, and then take your left hand on your left hip. Turn your chest towards the left, revolve around the axis of your spine, and then take your left arm up towards the ceiling as your shoulders roll back. Extend up to your fingernails, push down through all angles of your feet, and hug in through your legs. Good, exhale, release. Reset your body, step your right foot in a little bit, setting up for pyramid pose, Parsa Bhottanasana, getting into that back of the left hamstring here. Nice, and then from there, shift your weight forward into your blocks or the floor as you find standing L position. Bend slightly into your left knee, charge your leg and reach out through your right toes, extend up through kind of the head. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm a perfuse spitzer. That's sweating in Yiddish, in case if you don't know Yiddish. And I sweat when I get hot. So if you're not, start to deepen that breath, that inner fire, that Agni. Bring your right knee towards your chest. And then start to take your hands on your hips as you roll yourself up. Trust your balance. Trust that leg to bring you all the way up to standing. Bring your right knee to your chest. Taking it out into your standing pigeon pose. Yes, and then sit back into your hips. Woo! And then you can take your hands on your blocks. As long as you press down into the blocks, so lift your chest. Pull your hips back as you gather in the pelvic floor. Flex your right foot and ankle to stabilize into the right knee. And then if you want to go into your next progression, if you have that in your Canada Navasana, please go for it. Otherwise, staying here. Last breath. Good. From there, start to bring yourself all the way back up. And release your right foot down. Shake it out. Nice work. Okay, so from here we'll find our way into Natarajasana, Dancer's Pose. So bring your palms to face forward on either side of you. Roll your shoulders back. Now I'd like to break down Dancer's a little bit here. So from here, take your right palm facing up by your side, roll your right shoulder back, and then reach your left arm all the way up towards the ceiling. Then from there, shift your weight into your left foot, bend into the left knee slightly, and instead of snapping your knee, which I see a lot of people do in Dancer, pick up your right knee towards your chest first, softly curl your right hamstring, and if you can't reach your right foot, I want your right hand on your hip, otherwise roll the shoulder back, softly grabbing the inside of the right ankle, and then from there take your left shoulder slightly forward, left arm in, hug your shoulders together, and then start to kick your right leg back and away, and your left arm forward and away, in opposite direction, coming into Natarajasana, Dancer's Pose. Keep kicking and lifting. Kicking and lifting. Keep your ribs in, shoulders back. Lift up, lift up, lift up. Couple more breaths here. And slowly, as mindful as you set up, release. And shake it up. Good. From there, we'll do the second side. Bring your right arm up. Take your left palm to face up by your side. From there, shift your weight into your right foot. Bend your left knee, taking your left heel towards your glute. And take your left hand inside of the left ankle. Good. Bend your right knee a little bit. Tip your pelvis slightly forward. And now begin to reach the right arm in and forward, and the left thigh in and pull back. Some of you might have more of an extension through the knee, others you might have more of a bend in the knee. Find your own preference. It's your body. Last breath here in the left side. Come on back. Hug the left knee into the chest, extend it out forward, pointing the toes, and lower down. Okay. From there, coming into extended big toe posture into full eagle and warrior three. So from there, shift your weight into your left foot, bring your right knee to your chest. Option one, bring your right knee out to the side. Option two, bend a slight bit in the left knee, stabilize your left leg. Big toe, baby toe, circle of each heel. Reach your right, peace fingers on your right big toe, and bring your right leg forward. Or you might have enough space in the outer rotators, outer hips, to extend that right leg out to the side. Keep your right shoulder plugged in. As you push back through your right heel and pull back through your right peace fingers. Inhale, bring the right leg back to center. Some of you might go revolved, otherwise, cross your right leg over your left leg. Bring your arms forward. Take your right arm under your left arm, often one of the hands at the shoulders, right hand on left hand, or inside the palm. But if you find you're clenching or kind of bending your wrists around, I want to see the wrists and the fingers relax so your heart doesn't have to work as hard. You don't want to be muscling through this. You want to stay soft in the face and the arms. Good. From there, start to bow over your legs, chin towards the throat, and then release your right leg back behind you. We're warrior three. Your hands can stay on the hips, hands at heart center, or hands can come on your blocks. Inhale, reach your right knee back up and towards your chest. Extend it forward and point. Lower the right foot down and shake that left foot out. Okay, coming into that left side and then we'll start to take it down. Shift your weight into your right foot. Bring your left knee towards your chest. Bring your left hand on your left knee. Bring your right arm out to counterbalance. Good, from there, take your left hand, peace fingers in the big toe, extend out and to the side. Find the second side of Uttita Hasta Padangusasana, extended hand to big toe pose. And then from there, bringing it in, crossing the left leg over the right leg, unless if you're going to revolve. Take your left arm under your right, finding eagle, Dharadasana. Squeeze those legs for dear life, like the thigh master. You can crack a walnut with those thighs. Pull your hips back and down, firm your belly. Exhale, release everything back. Warrior three, or airplane. We're all human. It's okay to fall out. It's okay to wobble and to shake. Yoga is not perfection. Life is not perfection. Love your body where it's at right now. Let the physical teach you beyond the physical. Breathe in. Nice work. Bring the left knee into the chest. Extend. Point. And lower. Shake it out. Woo! I'm going to do a little breath from Kundalini. Breath of joy. You bring the arms out. Bring them up. Bring them out. And then you sweep. Inhale. 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 Ha! Inhale. 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 Ha! Inhale, 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 let it go. Inhale, 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 and let it go. Inhale, stress. Inhale, frustration. Inhale, anxiety. Let it go. Inhale, uncertainty. Inhale, fear. Inhale, regret. Let it go. Breathe in, whew, and stay folded forward. Let the head relax. Taking a breath in here. And a breath out. Walk your hands forward. You can take your blocks off to the side if they're in the way. The high plank position. Come forward into high plank and go to the outer edge of your left foot. Setting up for side plank, you can always lower to your left shin and take your right foot in front of your right knee for a kickstand. Reach the right arm up. Or you can always take the right foot in front with the left leg straight or stack the insteps of your feet. Roll your shoulders back, lean your head back, reach the right arm up. Next option, you can take your right foot inside of your left calf or the inside of your hamstring, thigh. Good, avoid the knee at all costs. And if you want to play, you can take your right peace fingers to your right hand, reach your right leg forward and up and experiment. Keep lifting up with that left hip. Woo! And release. Come back to plank pose. Woo! Mama. And then from there, shift to the outer edge of your right foot and find your variations accordingly. Breathing in. And out. Release the left hand down. And we'll find our way forward onto our bellies for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Point your toes, bend your heels to your bum, one set of bow pose for a few breaths. Press the hands into the tops of the feet, pushing down to your pelvic floor pubic bone. Lengthen your tailbone back and lift up your chest. And exhale, let it go. Let your chin rest or your cheek rest. Wobble your hips side to side. And then rolling onto your backs. As you roll onto your backs, hug your knees into your chests. Good. From there, cross your right leg over your left leg like we did an eagle, twisted roots. Lift your hips up to the right and let your legs fall to the left. Grab a block underneath that right knee if it's hanging in mid-space, so that way your knees don't have to overwork. Now use your left hand on your right knee and your right elbow and cactus as you breathe in for 3 breaths. Inhale back to center, have your knees in. Cross your left leg over your right, put your right foot down, pick your hips up to the left, and fall over towards the right. Have the block handy for that left knee if you have block with you. Maybe the gaze turns towards the same or the opposite side or looks up at the ceiling. Inhale back to center, hug your knees in. Lower your feet down. Find your block, flat and horizontal. Lift your hips up for supported bridge. And we'll bring the legs up, two legs up in the sky for a brief inversion before we close practice in Shavasana. A well-deserved Shavasana, if I say so myself. Let all the lymphatic fluids in the body return to the heart so the heart can pay the favor back to all the other limbs and joints in the body. One more breath here. Maybe take a quick point and flex of the feet, wrists, ankles, and hug your thighs back in towards your chest. Lower your right foot, lower your left foot, release the block. And then if you would like to, you can take the blocks, touch them together if you have them, and take them beneath your hamstrings just for a little lift as you settle into your rest. Take one more full breath in and out. Let it all go. Slowly start to come back into your breath. Wiggling the fingers and your toes. Bending the knees and placing the feet down to the floor. Rolling over to your left side. Pressing down for your right hand to come up to your seat.
grabbing your block if you have, or a pillow. And resting your palms down. Thanking yourself for showing up to do the work, to let that pilot light ignite in your hands, the heart center, and inhale for Om. Thank you so much for tuning in the power, the Vinyasa flow. Namaste.